In John 10, Jesus talks about the shepherd and he talks about the sheep. He also talks about strangers, but he's talking about people who are unlike him, who are trying to mislead the people. But the enemies of Jesus regard him as a stranger. In John 10, in verse 24, the Bible tells us that as Jesus was walking along on the grounds of the temple, that some of the Jews, his enemies, the text says, surrounded him. You almost get the impression of a mob kind of growing around him. They surrounded him and said to him, "How long do you keep us in doubt or suspense? If you are the Christ, tell us plainly." They were regarding him as someone unknown, someone like a stranger. Jesus responds, "I told you, and you do not believe. The works I do bear witness in my Father's name and bear witness of me." He says, not only did I tell you, but there's a whole body of evidence in the things that I've been doing and the things that I've been teaching that show I am the Son of God. And he further says, "But you do not believe me." And that was the heart of the problem. That's why they could not accept that Jesus was who that he was. They refused to believe him. Jesus said further, "Because you are not of my sheep." And then he says, "My sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me." Jesus says there are three things that his sheep do. They hear his voice, implying that they recognize who is speaking. He's not a stranger. Then he knows them and they follow him. When our children are very young, we try to caution them regularly about not going anywhere with a stranger. And one time I remember talking with one of my younger children and saying, "Now, if someone were to drive up in a car and say, 'You get in the car with me,' what do you say?" And my child said, "Oh, I tell that person no." And then I added this. I said, "Well, what if that someone says, 'Hey, your mom or your dad said it's okay for you to get in the car with me.'" And my child said, "Well, I guess it'd be okay then." And I said, "Oh, no. What you need to tell that person is, I need to hear my father say that. I need to hear my mother say it's okay to get in the car with you." Don't listen to the voice of a stranger. Hear someone's voice that you know to tell you what to do. And then follow him.